By now, you very well know what are estimates, when we use them, when we should not use them. But let's assume that in situations where we need to use them, where they are actually helpful, let's think about how actually should we arrive at the estimate. How should we arrive at an estimate or a number that's close to the exact value? Should it be very close or very, very close, or should it be close enough? So let's think of a number. Let's say 1148. Now, if we need to arrive at an estimate, it actually depends on the situation in which this number is used. It could be 1148 number of passengers that a train can carry. It could be that you shop for 1148 rupees. It could also mean the distance between Mumbai and Jaipur. Now, in these three different situations, the estimates would be different. Let's take a look. If you were to convey the total number of passengers that a train can carry, I think it's all right to say that a train can carry over 1,000 people. But if someone to ask you how much did you shop for, 1,000 may not be the best way to answer. It's actually 150 rupees away. It's actually better to maybe say 1200 rupees or maybe 1100 rupees. But if someone were to ask you for an estimate of the distance between Mumbai and Jaipur, if you say 1100, it's actually a good 50 kilometers, almost 50 kilometers away from the main city. Even 1200 could be too far off from Jaipur. Another 50 kilometers may be ahead of Jaipur, and a city is generally around 5 to 20 kilometers. So this would be around 30, 40 kilometers ahead if it were 1200. So it's actually better if we could say the distance is around 1150 kilometers. Now you see, in three different situations, the 1148 was estimated to be different. Here, if you look closely, this were the multiples of 10. If we look closely, if it's 1140, 1150, we selected 1150. Here, if it's 1100 or 1200 or if it's 1300, if we are jumping by the multiples of 100, we selected either this or this. And here, if we were jumping by multiples of thousands, then this would be 2000. And we selected 1000. Now, you see, in all of these three situations, one moment. Here, if we select jumping of tens, we will reach a very, very close estimate. If we select jumpings or multiples of hundreds, we will reach a very close estimate. And if we select multiples of or jumps of thousand, we will reach a close estimate. Now, in these three different situations, we could select any of them and the estimate would be actually a good one, depending on the situation. So what we need to understand is this jumping that we did of tens or hundreds or thousands is actually called rounding off. And in the future videos, you'll see how to round off. But the purpose of this video was to let you know that the same number, depending on the situation, could be rounded off. Or we could arrive at an estimate that is different, and that depends on what this number represents.